mission of Stop the Silence is to expose and stop child sexual abuse and help survivors heal worldwide. Prevention can be done. This is a public health issue, and just like we have a whole bunch of people on campuses talking about rape prevention and the equality of women and the safety of women, there is the safety of children. And that is a public health issue. And what we need to do is have people understand this issue. And what they need to understand is that there are certain basic activities that every single person in our society can put into place in order to keep children safe. Some of that is knowing that this happens on epidemic proportions, and that if children come forward reporting child sexual abuse, that it is almost overwhelmingly always true. Children don't make up child sexual abuse. It is exceedingly rare. And so that if a child comes forward, we need to know that it's likely true. We need to know what we need to do, both right in that moment, saying that we believe that child, helping them to disclose, bringing them to the right locations like advocacy centers so that they can report once and it doesn't have to be reported 10 times, at which point children often will start to recant their stories because they are overwhelmed and scared. And then everybody starts saying, see, it wasn't true, it wasn't true. It is true. It's just that you're overwhelming them and you're scaring them, and people are telling them not to talk and they stop. We need to know what it is. We need to know what to say to the child right then and there. And these are easy lessons. We need to know who to report to. We need to know what to expect from the situation if we do report. And we need to get help for that child then. Doctors need to know what to screen for. And they need to be asking the right questions. And they need to know what the likely responses will be. This is a public health problem. There are public health solutions to it. The healing process for survivors is different for each individual. I've heard some survivors say that they feel like they will never completely live out or completely rid themselves of the effects of child sexual abuse. And I've heard a lot of other people say as well that they absolutely have, that they don't call themselves survivors, even they call themselves thrivers, and that they're doing extremely well and really have brought themselves up and forward. I would say to any survivor or parent or guardian that's having trouble coming forward is to say that, one, you are not alone. In reality, there are people who are there to help you. And to realize that there are more than 42 million adult survivors of child sexual abuse in the United States. You are, in fact, not alone. And just imagine if everybody started speaking up about the fact that they were sexually abused as a child, you would remove all of the stigma. The shame would start going away, and we would start recognizing this as the problem that it is in our society and start to do something about it. So I would say you are not alone.